Hello, my name is Burr Settles. I'm a research director here at Duolingo, and I'm very excited to talk to you today about some of the ways that we're using artificial intelligence to improve the ways that we teach through Duolingo. Now, to start things off, I want to talk a little bit about our mission, which is to develop the best education in the world and make it universally available. And we're not kidding when we say universally available. I've been with Duolingo for more than 8 years, and from day one, we were committed to building a free app that does not put educational content behind any kind of paywall. And that's also why we use technologies like the internet and mobile devices to deliver our lessons to as many people as possible. But we care equally about it being the best education. Now, to a lot of people, the best education comes from having a private one-on-one tutor or a really, really, really great teacher. And while that may be true in many cases, unfortunately, not everybody in the world has access to a one-on-one private tutor or a great teacher. So we believe that artificial intelligence is the best way to connect the dots and really achieve our mission. And to be clear, we're not interested in using AI to replace great teachers. On the contrary, through platforms like Duolingo for Schools, we want to use technology to enable teachers to do an even better job in the classroom. But until everybody in the world has access to a really great teacher, we think AI is the best way to scale that kind of experience to as many people as possible. Now, when you think about a really great teacher, I claim that they have three properties. One is that they know the material really well. Great teachers are domain experts in their chosen field. Number two, they know how to make that material engaging, to make it exciting and interesting and motivate you to keep learning. And number three, and perhaps most importantly, they're able to get inside your head. So great teachers, because of the one-on-one time that they spend with you and because of the time that they spent with hundreds of other students in the past, they know how to understand the things that you know, the things that you don't know, the things that come easily and the things you struggle with, the things that you've probably forgotten by now and it's time to review. So what we've done at Duolingo is we've taken each of these three properties and turned them into research programs for our artificial intelligence efforts. So for example, when it comes to the material, we use machine learning and natural language processing to create tools that assist our world-class content developers in auditing and improving our courses. So this can be anything from analyzing the vocabulary and grammar content of our lessons to looking at scripts for Duolingo stories or Duolingo podcasts or audio lessons to make sure that we're hitting a target level of proficiency, be it beginner, intermediate, or advanced. When it comes to making the material engaging, we're using state-of-the-art speech technologies to create custom voices for our Duolingo world characters, which is super cool, and you're also going to be hearing more about that today. And believe it or not, whenever you get a push notification to remind you to do your daily Duolingo lesson, well, it turns out there's an AI algorithm that chose which out of hundreds of possible messages that we could send you at this precise moment to maximize the chances that you'll want to go and do a lesson on Duolingo. Now, those are just a few examples, but I'm going to spend most of our time today talking about how we use artificial intelligence to get inside your head and personalize your learning experience. And in particular, I'm going to focus on a new system we're really excited about that we affectionately call BirdBrain. Now, before I tell you what BirdBrain is, let me tell you a little bit about why we built it. In educational psychology, there's a concept known as the zone of proximal development, and it goes something like this. Whenever you're learning a new skill or ability, there's a sphere of things that you understand, that come easily, that you've already mastered, and you can do without receiving any kind of help. Now, just outside of that sphere is the zone of proximal development. Now, this is at the frontier of what you're able to do. You can still maybe do those tasks or learn those things, but you might need extra time or extra help. And beyond that, there are things that you're just not ready for. They're too hard at this moment. Now, there's lots of evidence to suggest that you're most challenged and motivated when you're learning at the edge of your abilities, or if you spend most of your time here in the zone of proximal development. Now, what that means for Duolingo is that whether you realize it or not, when you go and do a lesson, there are hundreds or thousands of possible exercises that we could try to cram into that 5-minute chunk of time. And so we want to maximize that time by filling it with lessons that are in your zone of proximal development for you personally, things that are not too easy or not too hard, but are just right to keep you challenged and motivated. So you might be wondering, how can AI help get you in the zone? Well, that's where BirdBrain comes in, and here's how it works. So for every learner and every exercise, BirdBrain can look at these two things and make a prediction that this learner has an 81% chance, for example, of getting this exercise correct. Now, some other exercise that might be more basic, it'll predict 98%. Like, this is super easy. But some other more challenging exercise, BirdBrain might make a prediction like 45%. This is probably something that it's too soon to try to put into your lessons. But that's all for the same learner. Some other learner who might be further along on their language learning journey might find this particular exercise a little bit easier, like 79%. And this might be in or closer to their personal zone of proximal development. So BirdBrain's able to do this because our algorithms learn to make accurate predictions from more than 5 billion exercises every single week. And this works because each of our individual learners have their own unique profile of the sorts of things that they tend to get right and tend to get wrong. So think about this. The next time you go and do a lesson on Duolingo, you're not only learning something new for yourself, but you're teaching BirdBrain a little bit about your personal abilities as well as the difficulties of all of the exercises that we give you. And this in turn helps us to improve and personalize the learning experience for hundreds of millions of learners all around the world, which is very exciting for us. Now, you might be wondering, how do we know it's effective? One way we can do this is to look to see whether or not BirdBrain is making accurate predictions. Now, this chart shows the prediction quality of BirdBrain over the first 6 months or so after we built it at the beginning of last year. This particular chart is specifically for the course teaching English to Spanish speakers, but we got almost identical results for all of our courses. Now, it's important to note that not only is the prediction quality high, but it's increasing and improving over time as more learners use the platform. Another thing that we do, and we do this for almost all of our product changes, is A/B testing. Now, the way this works is we take all of our learners and split them up randomly into two different groups. Now, in the case of BirdBrain, one half of those learners get lessons that are constructed using pre-existing heuristics that we've developed over the course of years. This is the control group. And for the other half of our learners, they get custom personalized lessons using BirdBrain. And this is the treatment group. And what we can do is compare learning outcomes between these two groups and see if BirdBrain is having a significant impact. So here are the results from one such A/B test where we used BirdBrain to personalize level 1 lessons. And here we saw a 3.5% increase in content length. So what this means is the sentences that you needed to translate or transcribe as part of the lessons were on average 3.5% longer. And this is one of the many different measures that we look at of how difficult the lessons are. Now, not only were they more challenging, but also more motivating because we saw a 6.3% increase in the time spent learning. So these learners were spending more time in the app. And we saw these same results again when we used BirdBrain to try and improve skill practice. We saw an almost 9% increase in content length and a 3% increase in time spent learning. And this is a pattern that we saw over and over again. In this chart, each dot represents a different A/B test that we ran trying to use BirdBrain to improve the learning experience in some way. And as you can see, in most cases, we were able to increase both content length and time spent learning. And in fact, there's a positive, statistically significant relationship between these two, meaning that if BirdBrain succeeds in making the lessons more challenging, it's also likely to succeed in making it more motivating by a proportional amount. Now, this may seem obvious or even easy, but it turns out it's really not. So let's compare these green dots to these blue dots that represent A/B tests that were run using more conventional product development and software engineering techniques. So for these other non-BirdBrain A/B tests, there's almost no relationship between content length and time spent learning, and a lot fewer of those experiments succeeded in improving both. But BirdBrain, because it takes into account both the difficulty of the exercises and where you're at on your own personal learning journey and puts the two together, it's able to strike a good balance and balance the tensions between these two extremes and improve the language learning experience. Now, today BirdBrain is used in some way for almost all session types that are in the app. And it's used in particular to choose the really difficult exercises that go into hard mode practice for extra XP or for the legendary skills that you'll also be hearing about today. And of course, we're working to make BirdBrain even better. We have ongoing research to make it more accurate, more linguistically detailed, so not only is there a 90% chance that you'll get this right, but if you get it wrong, it's probably because of this tricky noun, adjective, gender agreement, for example. And all of this makes bird brain more useful. So, if you're excited or interested to learn more about the ways that we're using artificial intelligence, machine learning, natural language processing, and so forth here at Duolingo, I encourage you to check out duolingo.ai. Thank you very much, and enjoy the rest of Duocon.